Hi, hello, namaste. Good evening, everyone. This is Dr. Kasigari Prasad, Associate Professor, Graphologist, Writer, and Motivational Speaker. Today, we will have a session on satellite communications. So, before I start the course, let me wish you all a happy Gandhi Jayanti greetings to you all, and with a greater motive so that we can transform ourselves and thereby can transform the particular things. So in every class I used to start this session with some sort of inspiration, because life goes in a proper direction only if we have inspiration. In this connection, if I have the belief that I can do it, if I have the belief that I can do it, I shall surely acquire the capacity to do it. See, this is very important. Then I can surely acquire the capacity to do it, even if I may not have it at the beginning. At the beginning, I may not have such type of ability, but if I decide to learn, if I decide to participate, if I decide to contribute, then I will acquire it. So this is the positive thinking, constructive thinking. Let's decide yourself, we all together as a good team, contribute ourselves in learning, sharing knowledge, and improving our sessions. So let me introduce the course structure. Our course structure has 5 modules or 5 sessions to say. In the first session, inspiration and introduction to satellite communication. And in the second session, we find satellite subsystem and components. In the third one, design of satellite uplink and downlink. Fourth one, LEO and GEO stationary satellite systems. And the last one, satellite navigation and GPS system, global positioning system. So these were the 5 different modules we planned in this particular course to continue. For that, the process is, we may have 3 to 4 live interactive sessions, as today we had a Zoom live session. In such a way, we have 3 to 4 live interactive sessions and 10 video lectures, and this type of YouTube live classes, nearly 5-6 live classes, and 10 to 15 video lectures. We will drop some videos to you to learn, to know, to study, and to participate in assignments. 5 assignments, each assignment has 10 questions, and finally, we find certificate distribution for participation and merit, and the course duration is 1 month. By the 31st of this month, we will learn and we will inspire ourselves through this particular course. So let me introduce one more personality, the man, the great personality, Missile Man of India, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. With the great inspiration from great leaders, we initiated this particular course on satellite communications. Now let me start the course. First session 1, introduction to satellite communications. So naturally, in order to evolve and transform the mankind, we have noticed that there are 2 important domains where transformation has taken place. The very first one is automobile, and the second one is telecommunications. Initially, during the evolution of mankind, they moved from here to there on their foot, from one place to another place. They have transported from one point to another point. But later, in order to improve the speed, and also in order to improve the position, in order to improve the transfer of communication with proper things, automobile communications, or to say automobile industry, has developed, and it helped and it supported a lot. Later, telecommunications. These 2 are the widespread domains in our human era. Apart from these, let us say a picture, see, my session completely runs through diagrams, inspiring diagrams and quotations. See, initially, the people walked from one point to another point, then they used or they have taken the support of animals, then they have created the bullock carts and cycle, bicycles, and 3-wheelers, 2-wheelers, 4-wheelers. Likewise, different evolution has taken place, and man started moving from one point to another point. So with the development or with the advance of automobile communication, or to say automobiles, connectivity has improved. Then the faster connectivity has improved for longer distances, for large cities, is by transportation by railways. So with the improvement with the improvement in the technologies that has taken place in railways, train has provided connectivity between big cities, so that people use it to transport from one point to another point easily. So this helped a lot in initial days. Later, let us say in telecommunications, to say there is a drastic development in the telecommunications. Initially, telegraphs are used to communicate information through Morse codes. So these telegraphs supported to transfer information in codes. Later, we know that how the evolution has taken place. Now we are using smartphones, and now we are connecting one to other virtually, all because of satellite is there. So likewise, a transformation is there. So initially, if you want to send some information, you use it to write on paper or postal card or some letters, and we transfer. Later, we talk to one person to another person physically. Now virtually, I am talking to you. We are talking to each other. So such type of things has been taken place. So a drastic development in telecommunications made it possible to transfer information and transfer persons from one point to another point also. So now let us introduce, in early days, early telegraph and telephone systems are used. They have been launched even in oceans and seas. So there, the information has been transported by using copper cables, to say copper wires, and they carry the signal from Earth surface across oceans to different places by using a medium called high frequency channels, high frequency HF, and also commonly they are called as short wave radios. So with the help of these contents, information is being transmitted from continent to continent, or from one country to other country, separated by oceans and seas. So this is how initially the transmission has taken place. Later, man found a lot of inspiration is there, a lot of quest is there in human beings. See, if I want to communicate from one point to another point on the globe of a longer distances, is there any alternative medium? A lot of questions, a lot of quest, a lot of zeal to innovate with passion and interest. They have started initiating artificial earth satellites. So this artificial earth satellite is a medium which is used for communication from surface to surface, or it is a great infrastructural medium to transmit information from one point to another point at initial days. So satellites allow people to talk by telephone. Satellites allow people to exchange electronic emails. So emails we are transmitting nowadays, and even we are visualizing to many channels, television channels, and this has happened all together by satellite communications only. So now the hero of our codes is the satellite, and that satellite is placed in the space segment. See, this entire satellite communication system is divided, or to say entire system can be identified in two, what is a modems or segments. First one is ground segment, second one is the space segment. In the space segment we have a satellite, and in the ground segment we have ground stations. So from ground station to satellite, and from satellite to again one more ground station, the information passes, the signal changes, exchange takes place. Therefore an uplink should be there and a downlink should be there. So likewise, two things will be, and we will discuss a much detailly about those uplink and downlink things in the coming sessions. Now my intention here is to introduce you that satellite is an eye in the sky. And in simple words to say, what is a satellite? A satellite is a physical body which revolves around another physical body, One is smaller body, and next one is the larger one. So smaller object which is revolving around the larger one, and that smaller body is called a satellite. A satellite is a smaller object which revolves around the larger object in a particular path. For that, the natural satellite which we have, if this is Earth and this is Moon, this Moon revolves around Earth, therefore Moon is called natural satellite of Earth. Now the question is, into this space, we the human beings can send one satellite. This is an artificial satellite. We can send an artificial satellite. And this satellite is now moving there or revolving there, and it connects the Earth at different points. It connects the Earth at different locations to say to the ground stations. Therefore, in simple words to say, satellite is an eye in the sky. Now let us discuss the origin of satellite communication. In the concept of origin of satellite communication, let us now start a motivating point with this particular personality. He is Arthur C. Clarke. He says that any sufficiently advanced technology is indistinguishable from magic. See, it's very simple. Let us visualize ourselves placing a satellite in the sky and making that satellite revolve around our Earth surface, and to say locating our locations, to transmit some informations, capturing some videos, and even connecting all of those things. It is a magic to say. So satellite, frankly speaking, it is doing some magic in the sky. So we the human beings created that magic. Now from this particular course, I would like to inspire you, I would like to invite you to inspire yourself and feel proud and happy such that we are learning about satellite communications. That too, seeing, in order to talk about this, there are two important things. One is NASA and next one is ISRO. We Indian Space Research Organization, we must feel so proud about it. And a fantastic amount of adventures has been performed by our greatest scientist. And we must feel so proud and happy about having ISRO in our country. And we are learning such type of beautiful and enthusiastic course. So it is our blessed to say. Now, let us discuss point by point about the origin of satellite communication. The origin of satellite communication can be very flourished to say by a letter or a documentation prepared and written by Arthur C. Clarke. He is a British. He is a Brit in a British radio magazine. He has that magazine name is Wireless World in the year 1945. He has given his views on satellite communication in the year 1945 in a magazine. And this personality belongs to British Royal Air Force and was interested in long distance communication. In order to transmit information for long distances, he has a lot of passion. And in the year 2000, he has written a book. He has authored a book, famous book, and that name is Space Odyssey. Space Odyssey. And this is a science fiction book in which he has established all his views about satellite communications. And this is the book Space Odyssey. So actually in the year 1945, high frequency radio was the only one available communication medium or method to transmit information over transcontinental distances. Later, this medium has been influenced or affected by hues of problems. Those are sunspots and ionospheric disturbances. These sunspots and ionospheric disturbances could disturb this high frequency radio link for a day at a time. Therefore, our communication system by using high frequency methodology now finds some limitation. Therefore, the telegraph cables that has been laid across the oceans in the mid 1800s, they are capable of carrying voice signals across Atlantic, but they did not begin services until 1953. So they are capable of transmitting information like voice signals. But the establishment of that one has taken long time. A lot of time is taken. It means they need a lot of change in our at the time, they need a lot of change in the technology implemented. So Clark suggested that radio relay satellite, what is that? Radio relay satellite in an equatorial orbit with a period of 24 hours would remain stationary with respect to Earth's surface and make possible long distance links. So he is the scientist, Arthur C. Clarke. He has said that a satellite which you launch onto the space, into the sky, if it remains there and if it make a period of rotation, one complete rotation in 24 hours, then that can give you a complete communication. Its radio communication can be provided by such type of a relay satellite. That is his views. So at the time, the person Clark, when he has initiated, at the time there was no satellites in orbit and nor rockets, sufficient rockets are not there to launch these satellites into the sky. But he has an expectation, if we launch a satellite into the sky which can have a total period of 24 hours, then that can provide you a very good communication. And but his idea for what we now known as geostationary satellite. A geostationary satellite is a satellite which makes one complete rotation in 24 hours. Very precisely to say, 23 hours, 46 minutes, 51 seconds. In that period of time, this particular satellite, if it makes a rotation, then that can make a reality, that can come into reality, and that has came into reality in the year 1957. In the year 1957, when a first satellite called Sputnik 1 was launched. In 1957, the first satellite, the Sputnik 1, was launched by USSR. And the first communication satellite, and the very first communication geostationary satellite, is Early Bird satellite. This is launched and it has provided services for telephone service across the Atlantic Ocean also. And what Mr. Clark has expected some 20 years back, if a satellite that is launched in that particular height can give you communication, and that came now reality with the establishment of Early Bird satellite. Early Bird satellite. Now, apart from this, in 1960s, there is a big plan to launch satellites into the respective origins, that means orbits, so that huge amount of payloads can be carried and services can be established. So geostationary satellite is taken place now, a very comfortable position. So geostationary satellites very soon carrying transoceanic and transcontinental telephonic calls. So transoceanic as well as transcontinental calls been taken place by geostationary satellites. And for the first time in the history, live television links could be established across Atlantic and Pacific Ocean to carry news and sporting events. This is the origin. I was explaining the origin step by step in an order, how the origin has been taken place. Then direct broadcasting through satellite TV has been taken, and communication satellites has developed drastically. And we noticed that in the early days itself, huge number of satellites are there in the orbit, and all those satellites are making a big traffic, such that for every 2 to 3 degrees, for every 2 to 3 degrees of separation, good number of satellites are there, and they are moving in the particular orbit during those days, in the early days itself. So geostationary satellites have grown lot of interest, and the size of that one, weight of that one, and lifetime of that particular satellite, if increased, then the services and applications provided by this satellite will also increases. Then some of the largest satellites that are launched today to day are Lacrosse's Surveillance satellites of United States of Nation, United States. They have produced these Lacrosse's Surveillance satellites which can give you surveillances. So likewise, different types of satellites came into emergence, and all these satellites provided services drastically. In initial days, these satellites has experienced a good competition with optical fibers. Optical fibers are supposed to provide good communication with high speed data rates, these satellites has to compete with them. But the only problem is an optical fiber can carry 4.5 gigabytes per second, a capacity similar to that of a largest GEO satellite. And optical fibers are never laid singly, but always in bundles. So there are optical fibers and they are providing sufficient amount of services incompatible with the satellites at initial dates. Now we know that there are several applications that has produced provided by satellite communications, or satellites has provided many applications in different fields, and we will talk about them. Up to here, this is just simply the origin of satellites, how the satellites has originated. To say two important needs, fundamental needs to say actually, one is to transport from one point to another point, another one is to communicate effectively to different personalities from one point to another, who are staying at different locations. For those two particular reasons, the evolution has been taken and satellites emerged in the sky. Satellites has emerged in the sky by human beings. So here we have a self-assessment. Explain the origin of satellite communication. Up to now we have discussed about how the satellite origin has been taken place. Now let us go for the history of satellite communication. More or less the history and origin remains the same. Let us discuss them with fantastic photographs. So initially, the first and foremost satellite on the globe launched is from USSR. And they have launched a satellite called small satellite. Its name is Sputnik. This is the photograph of Sputnik satellite. Sputnik satellite, and this is the first artificial earth satellite. Now we are talking about the history. Artificial earth satellite that is been launched by USSR. Then this Sputnik 1 carried a single beacon transmitter, only a beacon transmitter, and did not have communication capability. It means the satellite which is launched initially, the very first satellite, didn't perform any communication. But one success is there. That success is, it demonstrated that satellites could be placed in the orbit by a powerful rocket. That is the first attempt. And we came to notice that we can also, human beings can also capable of launching satellites into an orbit with the help of a powerful rocket. This demonstration has been performed by Sputnik 1. This happened in October 4th, 1957. And the very first successfully launched satellite by US United States is Explorer 1. And this is the photograph of Explorer 1. And the first voice is heard by the then president Eisenhower. And the message what he received is Christmas message. Greetings, Christmas message, greetings he has received in the year 1958 from the satellite Explorer 1 launched by US. Later, one more satellite, that is Core. The satellite, this name Core, was essentially to the core of Atlas ICBM. That means it is to intercontinental ballistic booster with a small payload in the nose. Such type of a satellite is there. And it is launched. And it has been worked in the orbit for 35 days. And after 35 days, it is failed due to the failure of batteries on this particular satellite. Later, the very powerful one, interesting one, to say a trendsetter in satellite communication, is Telstar 1, Telstar 2, and even Telstar 3, a series of Telstar satellites launched in the year 1962. These were the first of its kind which provided true communication satellites. The true communication satellite, that means the satellite which established communication, that is Telstar satellites, they were being built by Bell Telephone Laboratories, which is operated at C-band transponders. So C-band transponders are used, and communication initially and the first communication is established by these Telstar satellites. They used an uplink as well as downlink. The uplink is at 6389 megahertz. The downlink is 4169 megahertz with a bandwidth of 50 megahertz. and these satellites carried some solar cells instead of those batteries, and to charge them, solar cells are used here, and this satellite is the first of its kind to provide communication. But these Telstar satellites were launched into a medium earth orbit, MEO, medium earth orbit only, with a period of 158 and 225 minutes is the total time period taken by that particular satellite in MEO orbit. However, the value of communication satellites has drastically improved later on, and they have demonstrated to develop a huge amount of launching vehicles and try to push the satellites into geostationary orbit. And a lot of development and drastic developments has been taken place in satellite communications for developing and to placing the satellites in geostationary orbits. So likewise, various competition is there between USSR and US at initial days, and the satellites has been there are so many companies to say, what does the providers to say, they generated huge amounts of satellites, and those satellites are happened to place in the orbits. Now let me say the entire concept of history of satellite communication with the help of pictorial representation. The first satellite that is launched on October 1957 by USSR is this Sputnik satellite. Later, now the history. Later, Explorer has been launched by United States in the year 1958. This is the internal view of the Explorer satellite. Later, in 1963, the first geostationary satellite called Syncom 3 has been launched, and this is the photograph of the Syncom satellite. Next, in 1965, the first and foremost commercial satellite called Telstar, and it is also called as Early Bird satellite, this is launched into the space. Later, there are drastic developments in the communication for point-to-point communication. Telecommunication applications has been improved initially from satellite to point-to-point. So from one point to another point, communications has been improved. And in the year 1970s, direct satellite broadcasting applications in the 70s, direct broadcast satellite applications came, and we used it to watch live cricket matches at those times by using these DBS services. And in the 1980s, mobile communication has been provided. That means these type of applications has been provided in 1980s, and in 1990s, personal communication has came into account with the help of these satellites. So now let's see, there is a phenomenal improvement in the traffic of satellites. During the period 1965 to 1990, during this period, lot of developments has been taken place, and huge number of satellites has launched into the outer spaces. So in the year 1964, basically there are two types of organizations. One is Intelsat organization, and next one is Inmarsat organization. This Inmarsat means International Mobile Satellite Communication. These two organizations are intended to provide services like global fixed services and mobile communication network. That means for fixed networking and for mobile networking, these two organizations use it to work. So there are two organizations that use it to work for global fixed services, networkers, and mobile communication networks. Later, there are some regional networks also. Similarly, there are some domestic networks also. So in addition to this international networking, there are regional networking and domestic networking. Regional networking from one region to another region. Domestic networking is from intra-country, from one country to another country, which are of near in distances. Likewise, networking has been taken place. So let me say, what are the regional networking systems that are on those days? There are two regional networking systems. For an example, European Telecommunications Satellite Organizations, we call it as UTILSAT, and Arabian Satellite Communication Organization, ARABSAT. These two falls under the category of regional system operators. Similarly, there are domestic satellite systems which would like to provide, which provide services to some places or some locations between one country to another country, like North America, Canada, India, and Indonesia. This comes under domestic satellite systems. And all these networks, all these regional, international and domestic networks are intended to provide communication naturally and also to provide some applications of satellites. So what kind of applications are there means, these were a list of applications like application in metallurgy, navigation, astronomy and management of earth resources such as forestry and agriculture, even in military application, secured application, military application and amateur radio application. There are several, a list of such applications are there that has been provided by different networks by the satellites internationally, regionally and for domestic also. So in order to coordinate all these regions, in order to coordinate all these services, someone has to take care or someone has to monitor, someone has to organize, and such type of an organization is International Telecommunication Union. This International Telecommunication Union provides three different types of services, monitors, controls and provides three different types of services. Among them, the first one is fixed satellite services, mobile satellite services and broadcast satellite services. Likewise, three different kinds of services are provided by this ITU with the help of satellites. Now, Canada's first satellite that has launched is Anik 1A. This is the photograph of that satellite which is launched by Canada, the first national telecommunication system by using GEO, that is of Canada, is Anik 1A is the satellite. And even Russia used to have a satellite exclusively for military communication, by that satellite is Molinia satellite. So this is the Molinia satellite which has its own orbit called Molinia orbit, and in which the satellite communication provided services to various categories. So as of now, we have discussed what is the purpose of satellite communication, what is a satellite and what is the origin of a satellite and how the historical developments has been taken place in satellite communication. Now let us go for the other concepts. Now let us go to the other concept called, how is the basic satellite communication system? So this is the third topic actually we are talking: introduction, origin of satellite communication and history of satellite communication. Now let us discuss about the basic construction to say basic communication system of a satellite. Now we will discuss on basic satellite communication system. As I said already, in basic satellite communication system, two segments are there. One is ground segment, next one is space segment. So in the space segment, naturally one thing is there, that is the hero of our codes, that is the satellite. Satellite is there. So in space segment, you notice satellite, and in that satellite, it is intended to provide three different kinds of services, like fixed satellite services, mobile satellite services and broadcasting satellite services. So these three services are supposed to be provided by an element, an object, an eye in the sky, that is the satellite. So a communication satellite is an orbiting artificial earth satellite. See, orbiting, moving, artificial satellite that receives a communication signal from the transmitting ground station, amplifies and possibly process it, then transmit back to the earth for reception by one and more. See, let us say you can understand this one by a simple . So if this is the sky or outer space, here you find a satellite, Here you find a satellite. This is our satellite. From the ground station, when a signal is passed on to the or transmitted to the space segment or transmitted to the space segment, this satellite now receives that signal. It first receives the signal, then amplifies the signal. To say receives, amplifies and processes the signal. After processing, it retransmits the signal to the ground station. One more ground station. So between these two points, point-to-point communication has been established. Point-to-point communication has been established with this particular satellite. So this satellite is in space segment. Now, communication information neither originates nor terminates at satellite. We thought that satellite is, it is originating the information. No, it receives, retransmits. So communication can be established between all the earth stations located within the coverage region. So we thought of that you have some coverage area, that means a satellite can cover some distance, that we call it as footprint of a satellite. For example, if a satellite is here and this covers some coverage area, this shadow area or to this is called footprint of that particular satellite. Now here if you have one ground station, here if you have another ground station, this satellite can connect these two. That means point-to-point communication has been established by using this satellite communication. So this is the basic fundamental diagram that explains you communication system by using satellite. So in this diagram, let us see, you find space segment and ground segment. So in the ground segment, ground stations are there, which are intended to have some services. Services like fixed satellite services, broadcast satellite services and mobile satellite services. These three services can be provided by satellite by using the three different types of networks: international networking, domestic networking as well as regional networking. So we have a national network here, earth station, regional network here and it's earth station, customer premises, even directly from satellite to one person, personal communication can also be established. Now in the space segment, we have a satellite. This is satellite. Now this satellite is connected to the ground station and this ground station segment or this segment is called TTC. TT and C we call simply. Telemetry, tracking and command. So TT and C ground segment or ground station is there. So signal transmits between these two, ground station to the space segment and from space segment to the ground segment, in order to provide services to a particular coverage region having earth stations in network, national networking, regional network area and also directly to a customer premises. This is the simple diagram. You can take a snap of this one, very important. As I have explained to you, what is the space segment? In space segment you find satellite and it orbits in the sky. So, and that orbital characteristics are very important and that has been controlled by the ground station, like telemetry, tracking and command stations will control the orbit of a particular satellite. Let us consider that most of the satellites which we use now at present is geostationary satellites. These geostationary satellites are placed at a distance of 35,786 kilometers above equator or away from the equator, and that arc is called geostationary arc. Now satellites orbiting in such geostationary orbits are called geostationary satellites and they appear as stationary satellites to the ground observer. It happens that the satellite is stationary here. Whoever watches this or observes this satellite, when it is moving with respect to this observer, it is also moving and these two are linear to say always. Such type of a satellite is called geostationary satellite. And the design of that such ground terminals is simple and simplified. A simple or significant Doppler frequency shift is required to calculate where and how these satellites are placed. Further, in this single geostationary satellite can provide communication to large areas, permitting interconnection between distant ground terminals. So, altogether in a single line, satellite is intended to provide communication for long distance areas by interconnecting the ground terminals. And such type of a satellite, how many satellites are required to cover the entire globe, sir? Three satellites, three geostationary satellites placed at 120 degrees apart can cover the entire globe. So, three satellites, one, two, three satellites can cover the entire globe, which are apart of 120 degrees. Here, one important point is to be noticed in geostationary satellites. A geostationary satellite, which is at an altitude of plus or minus 75 degrees of latitude, they only supposed to be in geostationary orbit and visible to the terminal ground segment. Any geostationary satellite which is above this 84 degrees of latitudes, then they are invisible to the observer. Therefore, all the geostationary satellites are supposed to be placed at an altitudes or latitudes above plus or minus 74 degrees. They become invisible or unstable when they are placed at plus or minus 84 degrees. So, in order to place services, provide services to high latitude locations, other types of orbits are required. So, what are they means? Elliptical orbits inclined with 63.4 degrees to the equatorial plane has been used for this particular purpose. So, now we said that if the latitudes are increased for geostationary satellites, then we cannot have service because it is invisible and unstable. Therefore, we look for an alternative. Then what is the alternative? An elliptical orbit which is placed or inclined with 63.4 degrees with respect to equatorial plane. If this is equatorial plane, at an angle of 63.4 degrees, if we have an orbital path, then those satellites can provide this type of services. So, see, as I said, three satellites are required, three geostationary satellites are required to cover the entire globe. So, the first satellite will have footprint, the second one will have the footprint, and the third one will have its own footprint. And the orbits which are, this is a Molyneux orbit in which the satellites are supposed to move. This is a geostationary orbit. This is a geostationary orbit. Basically, there are three types of orbits. One is LEO, low earth orbit, and next one is MEO, medium earth orbit, and the next one is GEO, geostationary earth orbit. The use of low and medium earth orbits was considered during the early stages of development of satellite communication, the early stages, but later they were abandoned because of complexity in ground stations and networking architecture. So, LEO and MEO are not used due to complexity, and GEO is used to provide services, and the need for relatively large considerable number of satellites are required, and those satellites are sent for various applications. So, then what are those applications? Satellites with various advantages for low earth orbit include. So, some various advantages for low earth orbits include. The possibility of using handheld receiver terminals because satellites are closer to the earth. And the second one is they can provide stronger signal at the ground. And the possibility of reusing the frequencies is more often. The third one is the possibility of reduction in transmission delay. These are the three important advantages that has taken place by LEO orbits. Then satellites serving to the mobile and broadcasting services needs to transmit at higher power than do satellites serving in the fixed services. So if you want to broadcast services. When compared with fixed networking services, they need high power transmitters to say. And in the ground segment, naturally, we said that we have antennas naturally. Two kinds of antennas are used initial times. One is large antennas with 11 to 30 meters together are implemented for trafficking from satellite. And some terminals which are having 1 to 3 meters diameters with a simple RF and baseband hardware is used for non-tracking antennas for providing services to a premises, customer premises. So two different types of antennas are used for two different types of services. So here national services, to say regional services, national level services and domestic level services with including mobile satellite services, fixed satellite services are implemented in this particular category. Now let us see the environment, how the satellite is providing services. So a satellite is there in which it can provide services for an aircraft which is in motion. Similarly, mobile satellite services will provide here. Similarly, a satellite is there, again can provide navigation services for ships in oceans. Satellite provides services for land mobiles. Satellite provides services for a fixed networking. If these networks are fixed, these are mobile, and those services or those applications can also be implemented by satellites. So direct broadcast services systems has been implemented and satellites has provided sufficient services by using these things, and broadcasting of signals has been taken place by satellite communications. So up to now, three items we have completed. One is introduction to satellite communication, the hero of our course, and in that two important elements we have completed: origin of the satellite and history of the satellite. Then, sir, as we are talking about satellite communication basically intended for communication purpose, then how will be the structure of that entire communication provided by satellite? So for that we came across with the basic satellite communication structure consisting of two segments. One is space segment and next one is ground segment, with three different diagrams. One first diagram, second one, three geostationary satellites sufficient to cover the globe, second diagram, and third diagram, the services that are provided by the satellites, like fixed satellite services, and next one is mobile satellite services for aeroplane, ships, and land mobile communications. These three diagrams concluding three important segments, three important items of the satellite communication, including with the ground segment with two different types of antennas, one for 11 to 30 meters of diameters antennas, and 1 to 3 diameters of antennas for customer premises services. Likewise, we have discussed important topics of satellite communication in this first session. In the next coming session, we will discuss about many things on satellite communication. Meanwhile, we have next follow-up topics like what are the future trends of satellite communications and what is the orbital mechanism. All those things we will discuss in the next coming sessions. Okay, thank you very much. Thank you. If you have any doubts regarding this or any questions, kindly drop in the chat box. Later we will have an interactive session one-to-one so that we will clear all the doubts and we will get the information provided. Thank you very much. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat. Kindly drop your feedback in the comment session, and any inputs or insights if you want to give, kindly give it in the comment section so that I can have a glance on that particular things. Thank you very much. I would waiting for your feedback, inputs, suggestions, whatever it is.
Please,